Students, how are you? Hope you are doing well and complete your work on time. Okay, friends, you will also focus on your writing, beta. You have to do your work in cursive. Okay, welcome back to the English online classes of class 2 from Triveni Memorial Senior Secondary School. Today we will recite a poem. Chapter number 17, Granny, please comb my hair, from your NCERT book. Let's start the chapter, beta. Unit 9, poem, Granny, please comb my hair. Granny, please comb my hair. You always take such care. Let's recite again. Granny, please comb my hair. You always take your time. You always take such care. You put me to sit on a cushion. Between your knees. You rub a little coconut oil. Parting gentle as a breeze. Granny, you have all the time in the world. And when you are finished, you always turn my head and say, Now, who is a nice girl? Okay, friends, you have to read this poem carefully. Let's read about the summary of this poem. This poem is about a young girl like you and her grandmother. The young girl asks her grandmother to comb her hair. She talks about how her grandmother cares for her. She further talks about how she sits and rubs coconut oil in her hair. She tells how her grandmother praises her after finishing combing her hair. So friends, you also love your grandmother and she also oil your hair. Let's do some word meaning of this poem, beta. Grandmother. Granny means grandmother. Granny, grandmother. Comb, to straighten and set the hair. So we should always comb our hair. We should comb 2 or 3 times, okay, daily. Care, to take notice of something. We should care of our grandparents, of our things. Cushion, a small pillow. Knees, middle part of the leg. What are called knees? The middle part of the legs. Coconut oil. Oil of a fruit named coconut. So the oil we take from coconut, that is called the coconut oil. Parting, dividing the hair into 2 sections with comb. Okay, when we have to part our hair in 2 sections, that is called parting. Comb, gentle, soft. Gentle means soft. Breeze, light wind. So you have to learn this word meaning, beta. NCERT textbook questions. Reading is a fun. Question number 1. What does the little girl want her granny to do? What does the little girl want? The little girl wants to comb her hair. The little girl wants her granny to comb her hair. What does granny rub on her hair? So yes, very good. Granny rubs coconut oil on her hair. Does the little girl love her granny? Yes, the little girl loves her granny. Are you loving your granny? So very good. Yes, all are you loves your granny. Come to the page number 142. Do your grandparents live with you? If yes, so you have to say yes. If no, so you have to write here no. Yes, my grandparents live with me. Do you spend sometimes with them? If you spend time, so you have to write here yes. I spend a lot of time with them. How do you help them? I help my grandparents with reading books. I read them stories or any other things. You have to do these questions with your own beta. It is depend on your situations. What do you call your grandmother in your language? So we call Dadi Ma or Amma, okay? What do you call your grandfather in your language? Dada Ji or Baba. Do you know any old people? Can you name them? Do you know any old people, beta? Like Bade Dada Ji, Bade Amma, okay? Or any friends of your grandparents? How can you make them happy? So how can you make them happy? We should help them in work, or we should help them to prepare, to take some food or newspaper or other things. Okay? Have you ever gone out with your grandparents? If yes, so you have to say yes. And where? To the village or to the temple or to the market. How can you make? So let's read this answer. I call my grandmother Dadi Ma. I call my grandfather Dada Ji. Yes, I know many old people in my neighborhood. Their names are Uncle Harish or Rajesh, etc. I can make them happy by talking with them and sharing my experience with them. Yes, I went Shimla with my grandparents. Or you have to say like, you have to go to the temple or village or to the fair or melas, etc. beta. Come to the page number 143. Question number 1. Make new words using letters from the word grandparents. You have to given a word grand, parents, parents. So you have to make new words like star, star, rent, rent, rat, rat, grand, grand, nerd, nerd, ears, ears, and, end, and dart, dart, dart. So you have to make so many words, and you have to make the words your own words, okay? Sometimes we replace the name of the people with another word instead of repeating the name. So when we have to the words, when they are repeating, and so we have to use a new word, so the words are called pronoun, like it, I, he, she, they, my, you, etc. Like Meena is playing with a doll. So in the place of doll, we have to use it. It is a toy, beta. Or if there is a girl, so you have to mention she. She is a girl. Ram is climbing a tree. So in the place of Ram, you have to mention here he. You have to mention here she. Okay. Do not eat that mango. In the place of mango, you have to write here it. You have to, in the first sentence, you have to write here she, S-H-E, she. That is the used in the place of Meena. suppose you go to stay with your grandparents for a week. Make a list of things you would like to take with you for them. So, a toothbrush, soap, towel, suitcase, handbag, book, gift, a water bottle, a sari for grandma and the ticket. So, you have, we have to mention A with a toothbrush, A with a soap, A with a towel, A with a suitcase, A with a handbag, A with a book and the ticket. Okay? So, these things we have to collect, we have to ready before we are going, we are visiting to a place with our grandparents. Come to the page number 144. Make a thank you card for your grandparents. So what things you have to need? Chart paper of any color of 9 inches by 12 inches. Sketch pens, stickers, design blocks, etc. Make it this way. Fold the paper into two halves and draw or a stick picture on it. Write a message inside. You have to begin the message with dear grandfather or dear grandmother. So let's start. Dear grandparents, you are the most sweet and lovable grandparents in my life. My love for you increases more and more each day. Kindly bestow your precious blessings on me so as I can prosper and be successful in my life. With warm love, you have to mention your name here. I have to mention Ria. That is the name of the girl who is writing a message for her grandparents. So you have to write your name here. Okay. Here is a picture composition. Beta, look here. This is a family picnic. Okay. There is a grandma, parents, father and the children and the grandfather. Family picnic scene. Give name to all the people. You have to give the name. One name for grandfather, grandmother or the father, mother or the children. Right? And using the phrases given box. We have to give in the box. One family has come to enjoy picnic. They are eating food together. Rima is picking up wrappers from the green grass. The family is enjoying eating food together. Vimla auntie, so we have to write the serving food to grandmother. So mother's name is Vimla auntie. Rahul is playing football. The boy's name is Rahul and the girl's name is Rima. With his father, Vimla auntie is talking to elderly people present over there. Utsav is finishing with his grandfather. So the children's name are Utsav, Rahul and Rima, and the mother's name is Vimla auntie. And we have to use grandfather or grandmother with grandfather, grandmother or father. Okay students, you have to read this, recite this poem and learn this poem by heart. And you have to complete the exercise with the help of video. Okay, students, let's see you in next video. Bye-bye.